honestly, I'm telling, maybe more than 1,000. He will demonstrate one case. So we'll try to encourage them because they are at the younger age. So I'll request Prabhakaran sir to Anand.
We are ready, sir.
Shabir Hussain case is over.
We are ready and waiting. Dr. Shabir is just...
Shabir?
You want the closing picture?
Yeah, closing remarks. Yeah, yeah. It's still sucking. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Very good. Great. Okay, great.
Right.
Thank you very
thank
much.
You, thank
Shabir.
You. Mukund, nice. We'll go 1+2, please.
Now go, sir. I will hand over mic to Prabhakaran and team. Thank you, sir.
Somebody is presenting?
Yes, sir. I'm present. It's a 35-year-old male patient with history of bilateral loin pains for 1 month. On evaluation, found to have right lower pole stone of 1 cm and left lower ureteric 7 mm calculus. Routine blood investigations are within normal limits. Urine is sterile. He underwent left URSL and bilateral degestating 2 weeks back. Now he's been posted for right RIRS, which will be done by Dr. Datsun George, sir. Sir, handing over mic to you.
Hi, Datsun.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Sir, I have already placed an access sheath. So there was time. So I have placed a 28-centimeter access sheath. And I'm just using a Olympus P7. So I thought we'll go in and have a look.
Patient is little tall.
Yes, sir.
Because the access sheath looks almost inside, but still you are on the upper ureter.
Yes, sir. Yes, it's almost completely inside, but still, I'm just reaching. Oh, the stone had already come inside, so that is inside. I think that's the stone, sir. I fully put the access sheath inside. And that is the system, and we usually place 28 French junctions because we usually keep a little below the upper ureter and then do it.
Yeah.
If it doesn't go in, I put a guide wire so that it goes up into the system. So that's what we usually do, and that is inside the kidney. I think that's a small stone which was there. I think we can see the calluses. That's inside. It's Olympus P7 which I am using. Actually uses toes, this one. There are few papillary things there. Please put photo.
What is your experience in treating submucosal Randall's plague?
Yes, sir. We actually, if it is seen on the CM and you see it is just behind the mucosa, we just cut it open with the laser and clear it. Like medullary sponge, kidney and all, we have cleared on multiple calluses, multiple papilla which is inside also. We have done quite a few cases in that, sir. Laser, please. Laser. So it is seen there. I feel there is nothing else there. We can see the lower calyx also. That is the lowermost calyx which we are going in. There is no other stone. There is only a 1 cm lower calyx stone there. That is the lower calyxes. It has come up. It has actually come up partly into the ureter. Now, when we have gone up, it has gone inside. Yeah, laser, please. We have a luminous laser there, 100 watt. We usually keep it at 0.4 or 0.5 in the frequency at 25, 30. Not for this stone, sir. The big stones which we do, 25 to 30. Here they have a Quanta 30 laser, so we just use it. Move it a little more. Push, push. tip is a little, reduce that light please. Reduce the pilot light. Yes sir, we are kept sitting at 0.5 and 8. So let's see what happens. Where's the foot switch?
Mukund, 2 only.
So what anesthesia is the
patient on? Just move it this side. Keep it this side.
That's it?
Yes sir.
GA, patient is on GA?
Patient under GA, under GA.
Because it's very in odd location, so you might have to keep the patient in apnea.
Yes, it's under GA, it's not moving. Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
So what is your plan, dusting or making into fragments and removing it?
No sir, trying to dust. So actually as you said, the movement is a little difficult. Trying to dust it. Even if we can break it into smaller fragments, this will become very tiny ones. So they should not be.
Anyhow, it was problem. The upper ureter. So
yes,
if you break it, the calyx system is good.
Yes, sir, yes, it will come out. Can you increase the frequency?
Dr. Ratson, we'll keep watching you. We'll just start the other case.
Sure, definitely. Thank you.
Hello, it's a 39-year-old female patient with complaints of bilateral loin pain. With of 1 month duration, on evaluation showed that left upper.
Mukund, 1+2, please.
It's a 39-year-old female with history of bilateral loin pain for 1 month. On evaluation, found to have left upper pole 1 centimeter stone, with right proximal ureter 8 mm calculus. On routine blood investigations were within normal limits. Urine culture was. Grown E. coli, treated with antibiotics, now the culture is negative. She underwent right URSL with bilateral DJ stenting 3 weeks back. Now she has been posted for left RIRS, which will be done by Dr. Ramakrishna sir. I'm handing over the mic to Dr. Ramakrishna sir.
Good afternoon.
Most of the time, 99% I always go under vision with
So you always keep a safety guide wire?
Qantas has announced a lucky draw. The winner of the lucky draw will be getting a laser fiber as a gift. Lucky draw. Yeah, one. No, you have taken two. Give me one. Dr. Raj Gopal, Hyderabad. The winner is Dr. Raj Gopal from Hyderabad. Is he here? All the lucky draws are going to Hyderabadians. Is it fixed?
Number, this is his number, sir.
9848106032. I think
you can choose any size of fiber, sir.
Yeah. He can choose any size of fiber and you will give the machine free of cost.
Machine they have to buy.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
You can call him and tell him.
Yes, sir, I will call him.
Thank you. Done.
Sir, Prabhakaran, sir, this is the left side Ramakrishna case.
Yeah.
If the infundibulum is very close to the side of the stone, the laser will not work. By parallelly, if you fire n number of times, so it's a difficult one. Impacted in the upper uterus, unless he pushes into the calyx, till that time you'll have problem. Pushing with scope may damage. At the same time, there is no other option. You cannot basket it. So he is trying to laser a little bit and get some space. Laser a little bit, so get some space. After some time, it goes into the calyx. So that's the part he is facing. See the laser fiber. If it is at the 3 o'clock position, it might have helped.
There is one more technique in this, you know. You have to pull the laser fiber inside.
Yeah.
And put your scope in between the stone and the mucosa.
Yeah, stone moved. Then the surgery is over.
Yeah.
Surgery is over. That he might have done more than 1,000 cases, more than me. Because he handles my operation theater. So this is an upper calyceal stone impacted with a dilated calyx. Once somehow you push, but if it is at the angle extreme, it's very difficult. Or in the cup, for example, artichoke kidney in the cup, only iceberg is seen. It's very difficult. You can't bend. So in that case, either PCNR like that. And if you go the bottom of the stone, if you see all parts of the stone, that day you can do well. If you are not seeing any part of the stone, you don't know. That's my...
You just over. Pull the...
surgery is over.
Pull the fiber
yes.
inside.
Yes, sir.
And your scope should go in between the mucosa and the stone.
Yes, sir.
And after that, gently push this
yes.
fiber.
Yes.
Then, you know, you can get access to the 3 o'clock position.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, it's very dangerous. It might hit the mucosa.
Mucosa, yes. So, this is a dilated calyx. He sits and does. He doesn't stand. Calmly, he sits and does. Very fine fragmentation.
Dr. Chandramohan.
Yes, yes.
Sir, Dr. Shabir wanted to just show you the final C-arm
yeah,
shot.
Yeah, 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 please.
Dr. Shabir,
oh, yeah,
you are
able
on.
To see.
Yeah, it's complete cleared.
Running, sir. We are watching the C-arm.
Fantastic work. This is the largest stone, Shabir. Yeah, thank you very much. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good. Good.
Fair. Thank you. Thank you.
Without using forceps. Total surgery, no forceps used. Oh, that's great. Fantastic. Very good. No laser also. Very good.
Thank you. We are back with Dr. Datsun.
Datsun?
Yes, sir. As you told, so I just followed what you told. I just broke it. It's almost becoming very fine fragment. I think since the upper ureter is very roomy, all this should come out.
Yeah, it was in the upper ureter, so it should come out.
Yes, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
There is a question from the audience. Go ahead.
Yes.
So for a small stone like this,
yeah.
My strategy usually is to break into 4-5 pieces and basket them all out and give yeah. complete tears.
Yeah.
What is your...
there are two options.
Yeah.
Basically, the decision of whether to remove the stones or to just dust it and leave it depends on the pelvic calcium system. Like you saw Dr. Chandramohan had done one case of mal-rotated kidney.
Yeah.
My take on that cases would be because the insertion of the ureter is usually high. All the dust will come out, but these small particles will not come out. It will again go and land up in the lower calyx. So usually what I do is I make it into bigger pieces, and if it is a large bulk stone, just fragment into bigger pieces so that that stone would be basketable. Okay, when you go for a relook. So just leave it for 3 weeks, and before stent removal you go for a relook and remove all the stones, because in a pelvic kidney or a horseshoe kidney
water.
The most dependent part is the lower calyx. The PUJ will be quite high and it will not be dependent, and it will not remove all the stones. So the pattern of clearance is different from a favorable pelvic calcium system like this, because the stone primarily was in the upper ureter, which means the system is so good to put the stone, the large stone itself, in the upper ureter. So these small stones will naturally come out. So this
yes,
case, I think we should go with fragmenting into small pieces and putting a stent and coming out. But if the pelvic calcium system is not favorable, then it's better that you remove all the stones.
Yes, sir, definitely, sir. This one, the stone from, it was initially in the lower calyx, so which has come up to the upper calyx. So wherever it is, all this will come out. There is no doubt.
Another point I just want to mention, in case of something like that, smaller fragments, too many small fragments, in that case, as you said, you can leave it alone, because in not preempted, pre-estented patients, repeated going with the iridoscopes and coming back, it's very difficult in the first time. So you can wait for 3 weeks with the stents and see how many stones are leaving behind, and then you can, how many fragments are leaving behind, then you can probably end up with few, rather than at the beginning you will get a lot of fragments, which some of them naturally passes by this time. So if you plan for a second look, then it's better to leave, not to clear all the stones.
But yes. The major challenge remains on the size of the stone, because these type of stones, it's very difficult to catch hold of it with a basket. Even with the engaged basket, most of this will not come down, come out. So the best thing is, for these type of stones, we do a technique called coagulum nephrectomy, where we keep open basket in this calyx where the stones are lying, the fragments are lying, and then inject autologous blood, take the blood from the patient, maybe 5 ml, and inject it and keep it for 5-10 minutes so that it nicely forms a coagulum. And then once it forms a clot, then close the basket so that the clot with the all the fragments will be sticking on it, and you can just slowly pull it out. So this is one method for removing multiple tiny stones in a malrotated or a kidney where you don't expect the stones to be cleared. And this is not as easy as I told you. It is a cumbersome procedure, and within single sitting of this method, you cannot remove all the stones. So you might have to repeat it at least 2 or 3 times.
Sir, Encompass also comes in very handy.
One thing is that if too many stones in a basket, that can cause a big problem. So you cannot really withdraw the basket. You can stuck in the PUG somewhere.
Encompass, you
have to see the focus. What is the actual size of the, together, the fragments may be bigger one. That's the problem. Within the basket, bigger a mass. May not sometimes you can withdraw with the scope. So
actually, Encompass basket is very good for small fragments. For big fragments, Engage is good, and Encircle is just to transfer the stones. Yeah.
But this type of thing, Encompass is very good. It's
yes.
Just like a net.
Yes.
Okay, mesh like thing, and
because
we hold.
Nowadays, sometimes I was telling some patients next day also, sir, should I get a CT scan? Some patients are from Finicky. So such patients, I think,
CT
some
scan.
Basketing. Like they want clearance that bad. So such finicky patients, so better to do some basketing at the end of the cycle.
Yeah. Sir, we are now on audio with Dr. Ramakrishna.
Yeah. Dr. Ramakrishnan, I think you have cleared.
Yeah, it is clear.
Yeah.
Luckily, I not damage the infundibula of the upper calyx. There is no bleeding.
Yeah.
Almost there is no fragments in the calyx also. So
see, this, what I find in these type of cases, after 3 weeks when you go back, all the stones remain in the same calyx. The reason being, there is a little bit of impaction, and the wound in that infundibulum, immediate post-op it forms, the edema comes and sits in there and doesn't allow the fragments to pass out. So what I usually do is go inside the calyx and come out fast so that all the fragments come out of that particular calyx. Otherwise, there is a chance that the infundibulum will have edema which will obstruct the fragments to come out. And if it comes and sits on the edema, there will be a situation where the mucosa will be overgrowing on the stones. So this is one problem which we face in these type of impacted infundibular stones. So it's
so thank you. Thank you, Dr. Ramakrishna. Your audio is on, sir.
Ramakrishna, we are watching.
Thank you,
Ramakrishna.
Thank you for your wonderful presentation.
Thank you.
Two only. We'll get some closing remarks from Dr. Datsun as well.
This is actually complete. It's very, very tiny one, less nearly equal to the 200 fiber. So I think I have taken out that small papillary thing there also. That is taken out also. And this should definitely come down. So I'll just flush it. And usually we place a ureteric catheter for 1 day. The next day take it out if it's pre-stented. But since they want to usually place a stent, so the stent can be placed after that.
You don't want to keep a stent?
No, sir. Usually at this level also we place a ureteric catheter and we leave. That's what we do. They wanted me to put a stent, so definitely we'll go for that. So that's what.
Datsun, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Big applause to you for your work.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. On the flesh here, can you?
The winner of the lucky draw of Quanta laser fiber, Dr. Rajagopal, has come. Yeah. Request Professor Dr. S.V. Kandasamy to give the laser fiber to the lucky draw winner.
Congratulations, just got lucky.
Thank you.
All right, thank you so much, moderators, for joining on stage.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And with this, gentlemen, we have come towards the end of Preeti Urology and Kidney Hospital workshop on RIRS and Mini PERC, the 2-day very, very informative session. And last but not the least, I'd like to call on stage the man behind the show, the one who has been having a sleepless night to make this 2 days very, very important for all of you. Can we all put our hands together for the organizer himself? Make some noise for Mr. Chandramohan. Can I request you to please come over stage and give us the last words?
Thank you very much for that positive response. To be precise, everybody says that we will start with the faculty and then end at the last. I wanted to come from below up because a lot of work is done from the below. If you don't mind, my hospital staff of 150 members, each person is allocated one work. So they have done it till now. Still some work is there. Big applause.